Previously, I attempted to make my own glasses from scratch. The results of my glass, however, were not the clearest, which kind of spoiled their purpose. However, glass isn't the only material that can be used in lenses. In fact, most lenses today are made from plastic. But really, any material that is transparent and refracts light can be used as a lens. So, since it's in the middle of winter here in Minnesota, I'm going to use a material that is very plentiful, ice. Or at least it normally would be. Except we've been having some unusually warm weather here lately, so I'm going to be forced to use my freezer. The biggest challenge that I'll be facing, however, is making clear ice. As ice freezes, air often gets trapped inside as bubbles, giving it a cloudy and opaque appearance. Ironically, these trapped air bubbles was a similar issue I faced with my glass, and is part of why it also wasn't clear. For making clear ice, I'm going to attempt a variety of different methods. I'm going to try using distilled water so there are no impurities, boiling it multiple times to remove any air bubbles, various shapes of molds, and a couple of techniques to make it freeze in a specific direction. But while I let those freeze and find out what worked best, I also want to try a different type of vision correction that a few people mentioned in the comments, pinhole glasses. Using some of the leftover wood from before, which you'll be seeing a lot more in the future since I have a whole tree left over, I made a new set of glasses, this time with solid wood lenses. Then I drilled a bunch of holes into it. The science behind pinhole lenses is kind of interesting, in that it's a different technique to correct your vision. Because light bounces off of everything in every direction, if it just hit your retina, you would see a blurred combination of all light. The lens of your eye corrects for this by bending the incoming light to a single point on your retina. Various errors in the eye's lens can lead to different eye problems, which glasses then correct for. However, instead of bending the light to correctly hit your eye at a single point, pinhole eyeglasses work by just blocking all light except those coming from a single direction. This produces a much darker and narrow image, but allows the same pinhole glasses to work for nearly everyone, whether near or far-sighted. Now that I've made those glasses, let's check on my eyes. Many of my attempts were pretty unsuccessful. The best method I found were the ones that forced the ice to freeze in a single direction, pushing all the air into one spot. By using a saltwater ice bath in the fridge, I was able to force the ice to form, freezing from the bottom up. However, a fair amount of bubbles still ended up getting trapped. The method I ended up having the best success with was using a cooler with the lid removed in the freezer. This rose from the top down, resulting in a cloudy bottom layer, but the top layer was very clear, perfect for my lenses. Then I just needed to cut the ice to the correct size and shape them. Shaping my glass before was a laborious activity, involving a lot of grinding with various grits to get the right shape with a clear polish. With ice, it's a lot easier. I just found a large spoon with roughly the right curvature I wanted, heated it by filling it with hot water, and melted the shape into the ice.
That is actually looking pretty good.
This might actually work. That single concave shape on the one side was pretty close to my prescription, so I melted the other side flat by using the bottom of a pot sitting in a pool of hot water.
Wow, this is like crystal clear. This is better than my glass. I can see like pretty damn good. Huh. This is definitely a lot better than I thought it would be. Awesome.
While making the pinhole glasses, I made another set of frames to attach the ice to make my glasses. Now let's try out these glasses with a vision test and see how well I do. So first, without my glasses, I can read pretty clearly up to about the 20/50 line. It's NCKHD. So next I'll try it with the pinhole glasses. All right, this is kind of weird, but it actually works pretty good. I can read at least the 20/25 line. Actually, I could probably read the 2020 too. CRZSK. Very disorientating because I'm looking through a bunch of holes. It kind of takes a little bit for my eyes to get used to it. But once I kind of like settle in and let it kind of adjust, I can actually see 2020. So that is surprisingly effective, I have to say. The fact that it's very disorientating, I always see the lines between the holes. It also makes things very dark. I doubt I could use these at night. Well, technically improves my vision enough to be able to see 20/20 and be legally able to drive. These would be incredibly dangerous because I have like no peripheral vision. Like I can't see my hands right now. And then for reference, I have the glasses I sharpened out of glass themselves. And even with this, as I'm testing right now, I can read 20/20. So these are definitely good. My peripheral is not super great. It's very distorted, but honestly, I would feel safe driving with these. Definitely better than the pinhole and without.
All right, so my original plan was to get these attached to the frames, melt them into shape and everything, but they are way too volatile. And I actually dropped one, broke it, and had to reshape a new one. So here we go. They've become a little distorted, just in the melting of getting them here. But I'd say I can read, 2020. C-R-Z-S-K. Yeah. So when I first had these made, they were like crisp, like perfect lenses, perfectly round. But since then, they've melted inconsistently and they're about to fall off. And now they're a little bit distorted, but they work. They actually work. There goes a lens. All right, now they don't work. So to answer the question, can you make lenses out of ice? And the answer is yes, but should you? Probably not. They are incredibly impractical, but it is possible. And there goes the other lens.